I have the perspective of a long period of commitment, and I can recommend it to you. I feel as if what I've been doing is worthwhile, and I look forward to getting up every morning and keep doing it. That said, I have to say that the record of accomplishment is very slender, and there have been many apparent successes that have turned out to be just that, apparent. And it's been very, very difficult, particularly in the United States. I think in the United Kingdom, there's a great deal that's been done, and I'm very encouraged by trends in both the continent and the United Kingdom. Much of this I put at the door of the current administration in the United States, which has perceived the idea of governance as being hostile to management of companies. Now, as long as you have that, as long as a progress in this area is defined as a battle between the management and anybody else, success is going to be elusive, because if you win such a battle, you create huge damage. And it can't be fought as a battle. It has to be seen as being something in which all the parties have a real stake in trying to effect change to make what people around here would refer to as sustainable corporations. In this area, there are so many unintended consequences, and it was never intended by the people who passed laws that a few very talented class action lawyers would end up having the power to command the attention of the top of a company and command his attention to change the governance of the company. But in light of the seriousness of the cases and the fact that they've been pretty well proved, this gets the attention of the top management, and we've been able to make a lot of changes. Their involvement is critical. It's very, very important. They're punching way above their weight because, for a variety of reasons, which we can get into if you'd like, institutions of the quality of USS or Shell Pension Fund in the United States won't associate themselves with shareholder activism. So when we can come in with first-class institutions from the private sector side, it very much changes a caste which otherwise looks like being trade unions, public employee pension funds, and sort of known shareholder activists. So it's hugely important. Well, I think Spitzer, you know, it's the old expression of the people from the little state of Maine that I come from, and they say, what you see depends on where you sit. And when Spitzer was sitting as a prosecutor, he saw one thing, and now he's a governor of a state substantial of whose tax revenues derive from the continued functioning of these enterprises in his state. But he's an honest man. He's not going to compromise his principles ultimately. I think the Sarbanes-Oxley reaction is overblown. It is almost like a sort of red flag of rebellion that the corporate community waves to indicate how government just destroys jobs, gets in the way, and most of it's very unfair. I mean, there are extraordinary consequences of it. I mean, as a result of Sarbanes-Oxley, probably the single profession in the United States who turned out to be the most despicable as a result of the scandals were the accountants. I mean, the accountants, you know, have been selling tax shelters. They sell their reputation. And I mean, terrible stuff. They've prospered because of Sarbanes-Oxley. I mean, you could hate the bill for that. But as a practical matter, it's very, very difficult to understand whether, when the history of this time is written, someone will say that a dreadful harm was caused by requiring companies to spend more money accounting clearly for what they do. I keep lapsing into sort of clumsy maxims, but you know what you gain on the straightaway, you lose on the roundabout. And in a sense, the fact that the most intelligent, greedy people in the world are now committed to shareholder activism legitimates our category, as it used to be thought that we were just a bunch of high-minded idiots who were wandering around asking people to do something that didn't make any economic sense. Well, the fact that it makes economic sense is now beyond measure. So that's what you gain in the straightaway. On the roundabout, the fact is that their interests are very, very often very short-term, and not always, not all of them are that way, but some of them are, and that would tend to have a negative effect. To my way of thinking, taking a company private is a vast vindication of the concerns of myself and people like me, because what we've said for many years is that public companies are run with bad governance and that the governance artificially reduces the value. Well, we now have very bright people who take the companies private because presumably they believe they can pay an attractive price in the public market and get it for less than it's worth. So I see that as being a healthy working of the market. The market is in effect saying, if you have agency costs in running companies, as we're endlessly told, and they do depreciate the value to a significant extent, then the market provides a solution. Someone will pay more money, the shareholders will want to sell out, the private equity people will take them and will take out of them the agency costs, and then we'll refloat them. If men were angels, it would work out well. But men aren't angels, we know that, and so it's going to end up in disaster in a given number of places. And the trouble, again, is by fractionating out the different portions of the debt instrument, you've taken away accountability. I mean, if I owe you, it's pretty simple. If I owe some, you know, a million people who are participating in a Thai hedge fund, well, there obviously are enormous propensity for the accountability to be lost somewheres in that scale. What bothers the devil out of me is that without anybody saying it, at a time of great prosperity, America destroyed the pension system. Now, that's vile. Here we have the highest corporate profits on record, the highest CEO pay on record, and yet we're too poor to continue a pension system that started with Otto von Bismarck 150 years ago. I mean, that's obscene, and that's what's happened. And no one has ever really said that's what happened. They sold it to everybody by saying, you know, you're a real person. You ought to be allowed to invest your own money. By God, that's the American way. You know, we'll go out and conquer the West. Well, guess what they're saying is, if you lose, you lose. With a defined benefit plan, you have the company as a guarantor, you have the government as a guarantor. And so we transferred the risk of retirement from corporations and government to individual workers. And that's a sin.